Hi everyone, thank you Chairman for introducing my presentation. So my name is Motohiro Makiguchi from NTT Corporation in Japan. So today my talk is interactive 360 degree glasses free tabletop 3D display. So there is a contribution of our study. So we propose a new interactive 3D display system which has auto-stereoscopic and 360 degree motion parallax for multiple users. And the system has vertical motion parallax for various height support and real-time interaction with 3D data. We implemented the system with 60 projectors. That is one-fifth of the conventional method, and the display area is about six times larger. So many of the researchers here may have an experience of tabletop collaborative work. So discussion while surrounding a physical object make it easy to share the subject and to give new creative ideas. The purpose of our study is to apply such tabletop collaborative work to 3D digital data. Using 3D digital data makes collaborative work more speedy and more flexible. So for the purpose, there are some requirements. So one is auto-stereoscopic and 360 degree motion parallax for multiple users. So the key point is with no wearable devices like 3D glasses or head mount displays. So we think the point is very important because eye contact or face-to-face communication in the collaborative work is very important. So second, we need vertical motion parallax for various height. For presenting correct 3D shape for the multiple users at the same time, it is necessary to deal with the height differences. And finally, real-time interaction with 3D data. We propose a system that meets these requirements with one-fifth number of projectors and six times larger screen than conventional method. So this is a system overview. The system consists of an optical unit, tracking unit, and rendering unit. I introduce for each unit. The first is the optical unit. The optical unit of our system has a projector array and a spatially imaged iris frame. So there are so many 3D screen systems proposed with auto-stereoscopic and motion parallax. The basic principle is making multiple viewpoint images for all around the display. The conventional method roughly divided it two types of the method. So the one is time division method and the another is space division method. The one example of time division method is using high speed video projector and high speed rotating screen. Because time division method needs high frame rate display, so it is difficult to increase the frame rate of 3D images. And the rotation mechanism is difficult to enlarge, and the users cannot touch the 3D object because there are the safeties. So the space division method is free from this problem of limitation of frame rate and the user safety. So it's a very safe and can make more high frame rate systems. So Yoshida proposed the system using multiple projector and a narrow diffusion screen. So this system uses 288 projectors and 200 millimeter diameters the screens. So the increase of number of projectors is difficult to implement and to applications. So we solved the problem of increasing projectors. So we focus the visual perceptual mechanism called linear blending. So this is a comparison of the approach, the conventional method and our approach. The left figure shows the conventional method. So its method needs a dense projector array and the luminance distribution of the screen has very sharp and separated. On the other hand, our approach called linear blending needs use a sparse projector array and a smooth luminance distribution. So the luminance distribution is needed to the adjacent viewpoint image are blended optically. So the key point is adjacent viewpoint images are blended optically. So by blending adjacent viewpoint images, the intermediate viewpoint images are perceptually interpolated according to the optical blend luminance ratio. This mechanism called linear blending. As shown in the left figure, so the two edges whose disparity is less than fusion limit angle, so it's said 6 to 8 arc mean, are perceived as a single edge, and the position of a single edge is determined by the blending luminance ratio. We reduced the number of projectors for intermediate viewpoint projector by implementing this principle of linear blending. To implement linear blending principle for actual 3D system, we use a new screen that called spatially imaged iris plane screen. So this is consisting of a reflective layer, Fresnel layer, and a diffusion layer. The screen images the iris of the projector in the space. We call this spatially imaged iris plane. So the user can watch the projected image on the screen when they enter in the spatially imaged iris plane, but users cannot see the projected image outside of spatially imaged iris plane. The adjacent spatially imaged iris planes are gradually blended by diffusion layer, so this characteristic is suitable for linear blending. So in this screen, the main optics use Fresnel lens, so the Fresnel lens structure contributed to large and thinner screens. So for making a rotationally symmetric viewpoint distribution, the lens axis of the Fresnel lens has to be centered on the screen, so the projectors are pointed away from the optical axis. In this setting, the spatially imaged iris plane is deformed by lens distortion, and the focal lens design became very difficult. We use ray tracing simulation and design the Fresnel lens so that the shape of the spatially imaged iris plane is narrow in the horizontal direction and long in the vertical directions. We developed the screen with a diameter of 1,200 millimeters and evaluate the luminance distribution of the spatially imaged iris plane. This is a setting of evaluation of luminance distribution. We use 2D luminance meters. So this is a result of the evaluation of luminance distribution. The left figure shows the result without diffusion layer, and the right figure shows with diffusion layer. The shape of spatially imaged iris plane is narrow in the horizontal direction and long in the vertical direction, so we provide more wider vertical viewing areas. And the diffusion layer expands the luminance distribution to the horizontal direction about 6 degrees. So we set the 5 projectors with 6 degree intervals and evaluate the luminance of overlap. This figure shows the result. In this figure, adjacent viewpoint images are blended optically, and optical characteristics of the implemented screen are suitable for linear blending. This is a demonstration of horizontal motion parallax of our prototype. The prototype uses 60 projectors with 6 degree intervals, and the screen diameter is 1,200 millimeters. As shown in this demonstration, our system can reproduce 360 degree motion parallax with 1/5 number of the projectors, and the diameter of the screen is 6 times larger than conventional method. Then I introduce a tracking unit for vertical motion parallax. The tracking unit consisted of a 360-degree camera and tracking PC. So the motion parallax has two directions. In our system, the horizontal motion parallax is reproduced by multiple projector array and using linear blending, and the tracking unit is used for reproducing the vertical motion parallax. So there are two approaches to reproduce the vertical motion parallax. The one is physically switching the height of projector with, for example, 2D projector array or a moving projector. The other is virtually switching the height of viewpoint image. physically switching needs a huge number of projectors or moving projecting mechanism is make system complicated. So we focus the second approach, so that the virtually switching approach. We use a single 360 degree camera and open pose to detect the user's head position around the table. So the process is very simple. First, the open pose detects the user's head position, and second, the viewpoint image height changes by the user's head position elevation angle. This is a demonstration of head tracking. Our system reproduces vertical motion parallax with a single 360 degree camera and open pose. As in this demo movies, so you can see the changing of the height of virtual cameras. Now we show the real-time interaction unit. So the real-time interaction with 3D object is reproduced by rendering unit. So rendering unit consists of an operation tablet, a master PC, and 60 client PCs. Each client PC is connected to one projector by HDMI. So 60 viewpoint images rendered by client PC are required to be time synchronized. Therefore, the master PC sends operation information from the tablet PC and synchronization information to the client PC for time synchronized once per frame. Output image of client PC are adjusted so that images from 60 projectors are perfectly matched on the screen surface. As the initial setting, we adjust the keystone of all client PCs through the master PC. The calibration step has three steps. The first is hardware calibration. So we make a shift lens optical unit to adjust to attach its projectors. So the shift lens shifts the projector's axis to screen's frame. And second, we make the software calibration automatically using QR code and image recognition technique. And finally, we calibrated the software calibration manually. Client PCs output the viewpoint image rendered after collecting the keystone on the basis of the calibration result. Content is created in Unity 3D and installed on all client PCs in advance as an initial setting. So we use Unity 3D, so it's very easy to make new contents or 3D models. This is a demonstration of real-time interaction with 3D object. We implemented a function to change the materials of 3D object from a tablet application. We can change the material parameters, including color, gloss, and metallic in real time. So there are limitations of our prototype. So first, the screen quality is not enough because the hotspot and stray light have not been sufficiently reduced. So the improving the screen quality is as a future work. And increased number of users is a second limitation. So user's shadow became a problem as the users increase. So when users face across our tabletop display, the shadow interferes the observation each other's. The third is tracking accuracy. So user detection fails when the user bends the body too far forward or over the table or has blown out highlights. So we want to improve these limitations as a future work. So this is a summary of my presentation. We propose a new interactive 360-degree glasses, free tabletop 3D displays with autostereoscopic and motion parallax using linear blending and special image iris plane screen. And we make vertical motion parallax using head tracking system with a 360-degree camera. So finally, we make real-time interaction with 3D data. So thank you very much for your attention.
Any questions? We have time for one or two quick ones.
So what limits the fusion angle that you could achieve? So how fewer cameras could you potentially, projectors could you potentially use?
So your question is how we set the fusion limit angle? Yes, so the fusion limit angle is determined by previous studies. So it said 6 minutes to 8 minutes angles. So by this limitation, the height of contents is limited in our prototype.
Another question?